Hi there and welcome back to the culture we're focusing today. Like a rather small part of this galaxy, but nevertheless, the Suebi Protectorate will be a valuable ally. They're like 7th in power rankings, and we'd like to invite them to a federation with us. Why do we want to do this now? Because the Xolpi Empire has started to vassalize like a lot of strange states. And we should really be watchful. We should grab who we can under our bellies, under our arms, and yeah, we will protect them. They will in turn protect us. Maybe we can even get the Hanash Dam Trade Syndicate to join us. But for now, we'll invite them into a federation. It will cost us influence, but that is not really bad because, yeah, the defensive pact is cancelled then, and yeah. This will offset the influence. So, we're inviting them to a federation. They say yes. How is it called? The Glorious Axis. Well, I think we're going to rename our federation a bit. The Glorious Axis, really? I mean, it's not a bad name. We call it the Alliance of Logic and Freedom. As these are the things we want to emphasize in this federation. So let's see. Suebi doesn't have a lot of ships, but they have armies at least. They have quite some planets. They're okay. We're also okay. We're barely holding on with the energy credits, but that's okay for now. Our naval capacity will grow, and the future ships we'll put into the Federation naval capacity, there's that. And they will probably be more advanced, as they often are. Oh. And Lavizar Energy has been established. We'll soon join in some production. Yeah, we want to have that Astro Mining Bay first. The rest will be focused on energy. Paradise Dome and a little bit of energy. Yeah, but you cannot scrap this. I mean, that's just too good. And we'll also build, of course, some more synths. There we go. Now that we have a federation, let's see who we can give federation association status. Let's start with the Hanash Dam. We want them as friends. And the Cooperative of Carponia. Ah, they must be independent, which they are not. The Flecker Pact. They're also not independent. The Flecker Tribes, also not independent. Yeah, that's the problem, right? The Lunarian Empire. They will accept the Edirans. They are a vassal under the Xolpi again. That's crazy. The Pavilions are also a vassal. Then what is going on here? Nothing much. The Restorers, they won't probably join. Yeah, whatever is left of the Katik Empire can be our association status. They are all accepted. Nice going. glad to have the opportunity to work with the Alliance of Logic and Freedom. This is what they all say. I have considered your offer carefully and decided to join the Alliance of Logic and Freedom. Of course you have, because it's just great. It's just great having us around. Who is there? Let's send PDX1 over here so he can get a little bit of experience. Let's find out. And let's not forget about our ring world. Will it soon be developed enough? Not yet. The ring world site. Yeah, it's building and building and building. Probably will have another habitat before that. We have already started also for more energy. So we'll continue to go into that direction, I think. We'll not build more ships. We'll build ships for our Federation fleet as soon as that is good. And all now, we'll stop that. We don't need that anymore. There we go. Prime Expansion is a Gaia world now. Hope Horizon also. And Shlargos. Wow, our last planet we got, I think, is here. Of the Hovel. And look at that. There's only one militarist here left. The authoritarians have been re-educated, or they have wandered away. The restorers are collecting rivalries. They have a very strong war on them. And we might also attack them. I mean, it's definitely possible. The thing is, we could also let it run and have the Pretherin do the rest. A little bit in trouble. Because the Pretherin are not going into our direction. They're here. And here. They'll soon probably be at the borders to the Xolpi Empire. Yes, they are. They are already. There's another constructor here. I mean, we could send in something to protect that constructor. There is another of these constructors. Let's see. Oh, he's flying into his death. The Lunarians are... Yeah, of course, they are defending their realms. There's another constructor here. Already built something. Wow. They're really making progress. Ultrax Point, Nafobon, and Finderban's outpost also. Oh, look at that. The Katik Empire has gained that thing here. Crazy. So many Gaia worlds. So much more what we can gain. Can make this a little faster now. We should have a look if we'll find in the new system for a habitat. Is there still room here in Eton Stellar? I think there is one project could be made free. 1, 2, 3. So there could be a fourth in Eton Stellar. There's this unknown fleet that I cannot ever select. Yeah, I mean, it's kind of hard to find out. Let's see, in white space, is there something we could do? Yeah, there's also, there could be a third habitat we're building. Where should we build it? I don't know. Can we even build it? Prime C? Not possible. Love is out. That is possible. That is possible. That is possible. So, I don't think we could build a megastructure here. Or can we? Cannot be built around a star. Yeah. So we need to change that and maybe go to Between the Fallen. And we'll choose the Mega Rim to go back to Eaton Stellar. Because, yeah, there's still room here. There we go. Ah, look at that. That physics research, that society research. We're going to have very, very good research in the future. And already now. And you. Could we offer you some kind of trade deal? That would be, or a research agreement even, no? Information. Could have some kind of deal with them? No, they are not in need of anything. What is it, child? I mean, you're pathetic, but we'll protect you. Sure. I've always stayed neutral. Like the Swiss. Let's see, let's go back. Eaton Stellar. 1, 2, 3. Where could be the fourth? Maybe here. That gas giant. I think that would be a nice place. There's only two resources, which makes it easier to make this something not so special. How's the Federation fleet going? Nothing yet. Oh, and of course. Decade ago. Yes, we'll give you more. Artisan troop. We're okay with that. And a trade deal offer of the Scientific Directorate. Research agreement. Yes, totally. The Mega Rim is coming. It's coming already. And then can move in here. Yeah, not yet, it seems. Well, we have that station here, which is that one. Eaton Stellar 5A. Right, we'll disband that one. And now we can build a megastructure here. And there we go. Mystery Masters. More immigrants. Ah, we're soon fully occupied in research here. There we go. The pop sorting. Is definitely kind of cool. What do I do? An Aurelian, oh. Yeah. That's a little bit of a problem in these big, big galaxies, that sometimes you really don't see who or what is where and these things. Now we could integrate that, these guys for 155, my god. Now we'll build more of the habitats probably. We have Finderband outpost here, and in Yodbem we only have Bear's Fruit, yes. That seems to be nice. Look at that, we have quite an immigrant population there already. Member of the Liberty Now Center faction. What? There's only a robot. Well, we don't care. Pavilion Council research agreement has run out, but we're fine. We have the scientific directorate on our side for that. We might go for some construction for our federations. And now, synchronized firing patterns, better military station and battleship damage. This also counts for battleships. So, what next? Most important, probably either armor or hull points. Hull points are even better, I think. High density munition is kind of good, but we're going for hull integrity here. Going for the probably strongest upgrade. Let's see, can we have some Federation cruisers? Here. Wow! Look, they're so expensive. What? We want you. Let's build some Federation cruisers. Just some, I mean. Oh, yeah, he's got a cruiser focus, so we should really build the cruisers. It's really a great reduction of cost for the Federation cruiser. It's such a big difference, it's crazy. So we should definitely go for like 5,000 in cruisers. I think that was 7,000. Yeah, that's okay for us anyways. So look at that, that is interesting, isn't it? There's a massive influx of Pretherin now also to the Xolpi Empire. Hey, PDX-1 gained a level. Yay. That's also ready. Yeah, we can sort this in a little bit. And you're a xenophobe. What the? Yeah, you stay in the visitor center. Nah, you'll be sent here. Bring one of these guys here. That should be good. How was that possible though? He has arrested development. He's still getting some experience. And now, we have shield harmonics, better shields, 5%, so ships are really getting bulky. What should we go for next? Hey, we can go for the next shield harmonics. But we don't have a research agreement on that, so that wouldn't be wise. Energy credits could be something. But it's so crazily expensive. I don't know. Energy weapon attack speed would be quite okay. It would be quite good. Let's see. Maybe we can even have a specialist for that. Unit J14. There we go. So it's 75% here. And yeah, all right. Should be better. Should be better. Now, where is the science ships? Kalimon. Where is it? Here. Crestunian border. Yeah, the Storms of Kalos, of course. They have pretty good research. We'll give them the Rainer model. Make it assist research. There we go. Are there some new tempting leaders? They're getting down soon. Going down soon. Yeah, we have the 5-star admirals now. Out of the box. That's pretty crazy. I mean, they're a little bit expensive, of course, but still. Look at that. Wow, that was the one we were waiting for, right? Genius synthetic. That's one of the best choices you have there. And we have someone with expertise industry also. Oh my god. We have to think what to do now. First, enough unity for more domination. Governor skills increased by 2 and empire leader capacity increased by 2. I think that's just what we need. Really great. That's just what we need. Let's see, do we have even better governors here? No, not really. Agrarian upbringing is also good, but these scientists here, first that one, the genius, let's take him before he disappears, and then let's save up for the next one. My god. Swebi Embassy, do we have something here? That's our fleet, by the way. 480k. Where is the new guy? The new genius synthetic. Assist the research. Unit OR004. And a trade deal offer. They give us energy credits. And minerals for Angus Weber, yes. We need it now. We can use it. It's good. Also in the freedom system. The Calphadon, we should rename it. I mean, what should we rename it? Metally acute. Yeah, it's going for these puns is part of the culture as well. Oh. Unit MZ-34 has leveled up and gained the trait field manipulation. Good for him. Really nice. We've got another field manipulator here. Wow. We're getting so good in this. Let's see, where is the scientist? Where is the scientist? Yeah, we need you. Don't go away. We just need a little bit more. A little bit more. Hmm. Next month we'll hire you, I promise. OR004. Industry is just such a good expertise, it's crazy. Alright, so the Xolpis are getting rivaled also by our people. And there's something going on. Some conflict is maybe coming. Now let's hire another leader. Him. Or her. We don't really know. Let's see. The mentally acute gets that scientist. This is research on deep thought. Wow, these platforms, they are so crazy. It's absolutely super unbelievable. Let's change this so we have even more research. And same goes for this. And yeah, we're fine here. Really good, deep thought. And now at 52 even, wow. These are the little things. And these are other little things. There could be interesting things going on with the fleets. The Preferent Starbrood going over the Alliance of Roscan. So now attacking basically a part of the future Morthenweald. And no one is stopping them. And like the Xolpi, they're not flying in here. That's the crazy thing. They might have had the fleet. But in reality, the Prethren are just gaining ground around this little nook. Ah, we're getting one more core sector system. That is very good too. So the recruitment cost could be okay, I don't know. More food might be the thing. More food, more leader capacity. I don't know. I think we're going for one more leader capacity here. More food. Yeah, food is cheaper at the moment. So let's actually go for food. Let's see if we have someone for this area of research. That would be fine. Nope. Not yet. Then we'll take Zoroark, probably, because he has a custom AI assistant. Or the Raynor AI? No, we'll take Zoroark. He also has the due experience. Let's see. Where is someone missing now? No one missing? What? Here. Space needs balls, needs Alpha 2. Yeah, I mean, this is the end goal, right? Getting all... Look at that. Another expertise industry guy. The final goal is to have a lot of either AI assistant scientists or genius scientists, or both. Something on our mind has finished the surface construction. Nice. So it's time to sort. That's a good sorting. And you... Let's sort this out. Yeah, nice. Maybe this way. Should be good. Ever more research. And let's have a look how the Prethren are doing. I mean, The thing is, if they are not stopping them, they definitely have the fleet to stop them. And if they are not stopping them and threatening us in return, what can we do but let the Brethren be and prepare for our final encounter against them? It's the final countdown we are preparing for. This is absolutely insane. This is an insane number of invasion fleets. They're fleets of the Lunarian Empire, but they have no chance at all. It's just, what should they, what would they do? There are two constructors here that are already making new stations here. It's also getting into their reach and will soon probably cause another invasion. What's going on here on that interesting rim? Nothing much. It seems to have stopped here, or we just can't see it. I don't know. Homunda Blessed Mandate, that still exists. My god. And who are you? You're a xenophobe. My god. More and more xenophobes. Yeah, then research. Research something that makes you in a better mood or something. What? Morthenweld? Ah, no. We want you here. That's better. Going on nicely. Stardust Tales. I think we have looked at that already. Utkavongos should be in trouble in theory, but we could now request thraldom again. They're imperious again. That would be totally mad. They're losing that war. Which is really no wonder, I mean. Yes, it is. The Scourge is growing, though. I'm happy about this somehow. And somehow we're screaming. So if we're not going for an aggressive war now, next time we also have to consider changing our policies so that they will join the Federation. That would be very nice, because look at that. Relative power again. They're quite powerful. We're perceived now as not a threat, but rivals with allies. Yeah, the Xolpi Empire. That will be your downfall, people. That will be your downfall. So, the next thing to consider is changing our policy. Maybe to liberation wars or defensive wars. And then, in turn, taking in the Hannerstamm and then changing it back someday. Because once they're in, they love us. So that might be the way to go for this. So thank you for watching. Happy gaming to you. The culture loves you.